Okay, let's jump right in. I am very excited about this. I think that you guys will be too. I have no idea what's in here. Well, actually, I have some idea what's in here. I have no idea what it looks like. But supposedly TBS has sent me the TBS Tango 2. And I've seen no pictures, no information whatsoever. This is like my first reaction to having seen it. I don't have any clue what to expect under here. It seems kind of small, but I'm waiting to be surprised. I'm guessing that this is not going to be the final packaging like this. Ooh, maybe it is. TBS Tango 2 Crossfire Remote. Look at that. It's beautiful. Let's look at the box first. Do not transport if damaged. Ooh, there's a picture. It's a compact TBS Crossfire remote control. It is engineered to be rugged and portable, perfect for the outdoor RC and FPV fanatic. HAL sensor-driven adjustable gimbals, gamepad control buttons. Ooh, interesting. TBS Crossfire inside, open source software. So it has Crossfire in it already. What? Popping this open. Welcome to Tango 2. Purpose of Tango 2, compact Crossfire AIO radio, built-in micro TX 250 milliwatts. So it's got a Crossfire built-in with the 250 milliwatt version. Runs Freedom TX, more on that below. Industry's lowest latency, only achievable with an AIO solution. So they're claiming already that it has lower latency than other Crossfire versions, which is interesting. Travel friendly, obviously. Beginner friendly, price point $150, $200 for pro. I wonder what the difference between pro is. Probably has a bigger TX version. Unconventional switches for transportability, reliability, and durability. So I guess they're probably trying to get rid of some of the bigger, longer switches. Foldable antenna. The antenna also doubles as a kickstand. Interesting. TBS cloud ready, future proof. Solid build with quality components. Freedom TX. Freedom TX is a temporary open TX fork, fully open TX compatible, forked by TBS. Will be made obsolete in the near future and merged into OpenTX project. Okay, so Freedom TX is a fork of OpenTX that's going back into OpenTX. It exists because we don't want OpenTX dev team to work under our timelines. This relieves the pressure on both sides. Digital trim is adjustable on the fly, double click the scroll wheel. Freedom TX is fully open source, just like OpenTX. Hold down the wheel button to select model for easy access to your Lua devices. Click the menu button to enter the Crossfire menu. Okay, let's take a look. Get that out of the way. Neck strap. Good old, it's a nice neck strap. Some sort of SMA connector. Tango 2, some extra, looks like springs. And that's it in here. Well, I know where I want to start. That is tiny. So I have pretty big hands. So the scale is off. It's a little bit bigger than a Xbox controller. It feels just a little bit less solid than an Xbox controller, like an Xbox One controller. But it feels really good. That feels really nice. Those buttons are okay. The gimbals feel great. These buttons are crazy cool. Okay, so we got some switches there. Looks like C. It's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Position switch. Button there. Button there. That's a toggle, and that's a toggle. USB-C on the bottom, audio. Wonder what that is. Power buttons there. Oh, here we go. Wait. Get me all the way focused. Ready? Okay, will it power on? I don't know if there's... Oh, there's batteries
Welcome
in it.
Welcome to Tango 2.
Welcome to Tango 2.
Throttle warning.
So this only rotates one way. Throttle not idle. Tango 2XF Tango Wi-Fi. Here, let's switch lenses so you can see what the screen says. So right here, we've got the buttons exit menu page. Probably use a little bit more brightness here. If I hit the menu button, goes into that menu. Crossfire menu. And there's two options, Tango 2 Crossfire. Those are all the normal options in a Crossfire. Open region, max power. 25 up to 200. Dynamic power, off, frequency. 915. Firmware information, cool. Tango Wi-Fi information. I don't know what Wi-Fi does yet, but we'll see. You can see voltages there. I don't see a removable battery, but maybe there is. Menu, no, page. Oh, here we go. So here's model settings. So you can get in and do the normal OpenTX stuff. Swash type, channels. If I hold, it goes back just like normal. If I wanted to add an arm switch, we could do source. So now B would be my arm switch. Exit. Page. Source. So now on the channel monitor, see that one's there. So that could work. That's interesting. Very curious about these buttons on the back. Here, we'll get some more detail shots here for you. So yeah, you got your exit menu page. There's the sticks. They're pretty short by default, but it looks like it's the standard way to change them. So bring it out to there, which is more my style. The gimbals really feel fine. They're not, you know, blowing me away because I'm, you know, to be honest, used to Futaba. But I'm like, it's fine. Definitely fly a drone with that for sure. Got a neck strap connector right there in the middle, pretty well balanced, it looks like. You can see that antenna. A little bit more light here. And it just spins up like that on that joint. Doesn't feel chintzy at all, it should be good. And it uses it like a stand like that, which is pretty sweet. You got all your switches here on the back, inputs. On the back, you got these F and E switches. Cool. This is that roller. It's a little, so I've been having trouble like clicking it and rolling it. Like I accidentally like move it as I click it sometimes, a couple times, but I mean, not bother me. This looks like it's going to correspond to the Crossfire colors. So like when this is green, it's bound, and when it's yellow, it's not bound. So that should be pretty nice. But yeah, it's looking great. Let's get it bound up to a drone and try it out.
So I've come out here without actually even having maidened this quad because I wanted to make sure that my first impressions, my first experience with the TBS Tango 2 were genuine. Like I didn't even like maiden flight, like hover tested at the house. Like this is my first experience with it. So just so you know, like everything that we're about to do, all the flying we're about to do is me flying it for the exact first time. So the first thing that I want to point out while I'm out here in the field is that they were not joking about the portability. Like this whole pouch here is normally for my radio. It's just this little guy sitting in here. There's nothing to it. It's pretty cool. I am a big fan of that the fact that it's just so tiny. Okay, so we're out here at Church A. This is like my go-to flying spot. I've got my DJI digital FPV system and the new TBS Tango 2 radio, as well as a HD Project 399 Super G. And we're gonna give this a rip. I've got GoPro on for a little chesty cam action so you can see what the radio is seeing or what I'm doing on the radio. And let's get flying. I just wanna get up in the air, cruise, see what it's like, feel like what it's like in my hands. I did a little bit of simming on the DRL sim before I came over. Felt pretty good there. Maybe a little bit uncomfortable for me for racing, but remember, I'm a pincher, so that's going to be something else that we have to factor into the fact that, you know, it's just sometimes radios are just up to preference. So I'm excited to just fly it around a little bit. We'll talk about what we're experiencing and get out there.
Welcome to Tango 2.
So I'm getting a throttle warning every time I power it up, but I assume that I just have some sort of setting wrong. Right now I've got this down to my arm switch, which is pretty cool. But yeah, like, so that's arm instead of like this switch or something, which I think is kind of cool. So we'll see what we think about that. Oh, this is also a maiden flight, by the way. I should do this line of sight. Seems good enough to me. Okay, here we go. So when I first saw it, I was worried it was gonna be rough for pinchers, but honestly, like, it doesn't feel bad at all for pinching. There's, like, I think my preference is still for like big tray radios for that. Saved it. But yeah, it feels really solid. The connection feels really good. Oh, I'm an idiot. And I kicked my battery out. Be right back. I guess for a first flight, like, nothing to report is probably a pretty good report. Like, it's just, I just flew. It was normal. Yeah, we'll see. I just hit the ground like an idiot because I was trying to do a flip over backwards, stall, and then flip over. And I just beamed it into the ground like a dumbass. But it's not like I look weird or anything walking around with goggles on my head, GoPro. Got a receiver in my pocket for the audio. And a drone, like, look, first flight, destroyed that battery lead. So one of the important things that I need to be testing out with this is that there's a lower latency than normal Crossfire because of the all-in-one package. Now, obviously it's going to be hard to tell that right now with the fact that I'm running the DJI digital FPV system, which adds a little bit of latency. But for now, feels good. Definitely on par with what I'm used to flying with the DJI system. I'm getting used to my rates again. These are my freestyle rates. I've been not running a lot of freestyle lately, so I'm super used to different kind of stuff. Okay, so I accidentally just hit a button. My middle finger right here is on my right hand, is resting on the switch that's there, and I accidentally pushed the switch, which all it does is turn on the beeper when I'm not in the air, so it's not the end of the world, but like if my arm switch was there, I would have accidentally disarmed. So something to think about. It's interesting that my DJI system is not giving me battery voltage. I'm gonna have to take a look at that. Oh, I forgot to wire it up. I know why. Oh, I forgot where my disarm switch was. And I think my battery's off again. So I forgot that I put the switch here instead of here. And I forgot to disarm. We're walking again. Man, every time I come out to test something and like bring cameras and stuff, I fly like garbage and I can't keep it in the air. And now I just look like I'm terrible at flying. Maybe you guys already thought I was terrible at flying.
Cheeky.
Okay, well, we're out here. Let's do some really basic range testing. So like on the other side of the field over there is a good bit of range. Not amazing, but on 100 milliwatt output on the radio, we're just gonna go that way and see what happens. We won't go over the lake though. So I'm a bit of a chicken. Go nice and chill through this little path back here. Video's kind of blocky right now. Are you kidding me? I can't fly. I'm done. Looks like we're walking again.
Okay.
Totally my fault. Just bumped into a tree I didn't see. We'll go get that. Try again.
Well, I suppose it could have been a lot worse. I hit this branch here, and the quad is right back in there. But if it had gone equally distant the opposite way, yeah, it would have been in water. So, should at least be grateful that it did not go that way.
Are you kidding me? Come on. This suck fest is continuing because now I broke a prop and apparently I didn't bring my prop tool or any prop tool. There's no spare one in my bag for some reason. I just want to fly a little bit. Well, we're heading home. Just this. This is all I needed. Prop tool right there. Let's go. Okay, new spot. I'm not gonna mess around with setting up the GoPro and all that. I'm just gonna go fly. So video will be over here. I'll be over here. Let's just get it done. I don't even have anything to say for that one. Like, I was just having a good time flying. My bad, I forgot to talk. It seems like there's kind of like a little bit of a delay on this switch here, this toggle. Not like anything absurd, but like just enough that I notice it when I'm setting it down that like my landings are not quite as smooth as I usually like them to be. But I think that's just because I have to wait for it to come back out rather than just the instant it switches going away. So I think that'll do it for flight testing with the TBS Tango. I'm gonna keep playing with it for probably another week and just keep flying it once in a while and continuing to build up my thoughts on it. I am super stoked about it. It seems like something that's gonna go in my bag and I'm gonna take with me places and use for long range or short range or medium range or whatever people wanna call it these days. I can't wait to go flying again, like just to be able to pull this out. I'm really stoked that it works with the simulator. And so we'll keep going on the actual review of this, a little bit more details, a little bit all of that kind of stuff. But I hope this gives you a good sense of like kind of my first reaction to it. And I hope that you learned what you wanted to learn about the TBS Tango 2 today. So thanks for watching. Thanks so much to TBS for sending out this product. Actually, this is like my first partnership with TBS. Like, they've never sent me something for review before. So I was super excited to be a part of that. Trappy reached out to me directly and said, hey, you want to check this out? I'm like, yes. And more than that, I want to be part of the TBS family because I love all of their stuff. I use everything. It's a blast. Unifies and everything, except which is DJI, Crossfire, all that stuff. So I'm really, really stoked to be a part of it. And I hope that you guys get to learn something today about that. Ooh, that sounded like Bardwell. I hope that you guys enjoyed the opportunity to view this video. Anyway, stay flying.